I'm looking for big bucks. I won't be working, you will be working.
Lord Sugar's on the hunt for a brand new business partner.
The whole point of this is to prove that we can start a business with £250,000. This is not about chancing your arm. I want a business model, a business plan. I want someone who's going to go for it.
Ready to fight for his funding, 20 aspiring entrepreneurs.
This place is full of sharks. You've got a noose here around your neck. I am the judge, jury, and executioner.
On the table, a £250,000 investment and a 50-50 partnership with Britain's toughest backer.
Someone must think they're being clever. That is not a bleeding skeleton, OK? That's a skeleton.
Right, guys, go, go, go.
It's a deal worth fighting for.
I am like three times worse sexual than you are, Daniel.
Great.
That performance is absolutely appalling.
You basically just stole that diamond off him.
20 candidates.
I just feel so proud of what we have done.
12 tough weeks.
What do men dislike the most, vegetables, waxing or cricket?
One life-changing opportunity.
You're fired. You're fired. You have got a lot to learn. You're fired.
Laura Sugar is downstairs.
Previously on The Apprentice.
Now, one of you is going to be my business partner, and part of business is negotiation.
One day to find 9 items.
Diamonds. Oh, my goodness.
At the best possible price.
I think it's worth taking a little bit more time.
Project manager Sanjay stayed put.
An extra half an hour spent here planning the day could save us hours later.
Solomon bagged some bones.
I quite like the look of Steve over here. He looks like a skeleton for me.
Oh, my God, it looks perfect.
And for Roisin...
Could we save £50 and we have a deal?
A gem of a purchase.
OK, 50.
£50. Super.
On the other team...
Oh, shalom, how are you doing?
Daniel took the lead.
Give me it for four, just for four. For me, Yakov, come on.
And Felipe took a chance.
Fully sized.
Yep.
Anatomical skeleton.
Thought right outside the box. I'm really proud of you, mate. Really good.
But in the boardroom...
What is this?
A body blow.
Someone must think they're being clever.
Yeah. This is a full-size anatomical...
It is not a skeleton. End of story.
Sanjay came under fire.
The fact that you went all the way to Stratford may have prevented us from getting some of the other products.
But a win saved his skin.
Whose bloody brainstorm was this?
And Felipe took the fall.
Felipe, you're fired.
He became the 13th casualty of the boardroom. Now 7 remain to fight for the chance to become Lord Sugar's business partner. Six a.m.
Hello?
Good morning. Lord Sugar would like you to meet him at Tate Britain. The cars will be outside in 20 minutes.
OK, thanks. Guys! Everybody up! Tate Britain in 20 minutes.
Let's go.
Like the art gallery?
I presume so.
That people want to paint our own pictures and stuff.
I don't think anyone will buy those.
It's an art task, I tell you what. With my accent, I'm in big trouble.
For me, this is big.
We've lost too many tasks. I'm hoping statistically...
You've got the worst record in the process, haven't you?
Our second worst. Daniel's got the worst. We got to win this. That's the simplest rule here. We've got to win.
For me, it's do or die. If I don't win this task, and I'm in for the 5th time, I'm banging trouble.
Yeah.
There's that few of us that everyone is going to have to be able to justify exactly what they're doing on this task.
Millbank, home to world-famous gallery Tate Britain. Thank you.
Good morning.
Good morning, Lord Sugar.
Well, welcome to Tate Britain, built by Sir Henry Tate to house his collection. Sir Henry was an entrepreneur who made his fortune out of sugar, and that's exactly what this task is all about. Premium puddings. These take their inspiration from high-end dining, but are then aimed at the mass market. You are going to have to come up with a range of desserts, and you're going to pitch them to three retailers that I've laid on. And it's very simple. The team that comes up with the most amount of orders will win, and in the losing team, at least one of you will be fired. Now, Daniel, over the past few weeks, we've had a little, I suppose to put it mildly, argy-bargy with your team. So what I'd like you to do is to step over to this team here. And Sanjay, you step over to this team here. Now, Rasheen, I understand you want to go into the ready meal business. So you're going to be the project manager on this particular task. And Katie, I know you want to open a restaurant with me. So you can be the project manager. So, everything clear?
Yes, sir.
Well, good luck. I'll see you in the boardroom in a few days' time. Off you go.
Thank you, Lord Sugar.
With over 600 million a year spent on chilled desserts, premium puddings can produce a tasty profit. Teams must create their own pudding brand before pitching tomorrow to three leading supermarkets.
Guys, I'm absolutely over the moon joining you two. I couldn't put up any more of Bianca covering her back.
Mate, it's good to have you.
Heading up her team.
I think we need to take a chance here in developing something premium, but also original and new.
Ready meal hopeful, Roisin.
Does anybody else have any thoughts?
I've got an idea around British-inspired cheesecakes for summer.
I think we could have something like a tease cake instead of a cheesecake.
I do think the word tea would be nice to have a play on that word somehow, you know, tea.
It's like teapot or like tea.
That's kind of fun.
It's like teapot, teapot they like, are like...
Yeah, I do want tea in there.
Down the hall.
This is what my business plan's all about, creating things that people want to eat.
Putting forward her recipe for success, project manager Katie.
We're not pitching it to a Michelin star restaurant, we're pitching it to a normal supermarket where people want what they like, but with a different twist on it.
Okay.
I'm really pleased to be project manager on this task. This is right up my street. My business plan is all about food and creating a healthy eating restaurant, so this is perfect for me. It makes sense, given what my business plan is, for me to go to the manufacturing and select the flavours, and you guys are going to go and create the branding.
Cool.
It needs to stand out on the shelf. It needs to be not bland.
OK.
I'm definitely going to do the packaging and branding. Who feels confident doing the manufacture?
Well, I was going to say I'd love to do the branding.
I would quite like to be on branding.
I'm going to take Bianca with me, branding.
I just want to raise the fact that, you know, I don't drink tea. I don't think I'll be the best placed. I mean, you've seen me in the kitchen.
If you feel you can't do it, that's okay.
Throughout this process, I've been very creative, very, very strong branding.
I don't know where the strength in branding has come out, to be honest.
Well, for the board game, I branded it.
Okay, well, let's move on then.
Yeah, absolutely.
You're okay with that, Bianca?
Oh, fine. Support the team effort.
Who's PM? Roisin's PM. Why? Because ready meals are the core of her business plan. She started off well, but 3 minutes later, she had her mind changed for her. When Solomon demanded to go on the packaging team and Bianca was shoved onto manufacturing...
That's a bad start.
OK, great, let's go.
10:30. The teams hit the road to find out what's hot in the world of puddings.
Yeah, so can you, like, explain the tea concept, like...
Say chamomile tea.
Yeah.
The taste of chamomile tea.
Is that caramel flavour?
Yeah.
So it does taste like caramel kind of thing?
Not caramel.
Oh, that's what I was saying.
No, 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 not caramel.
Oh, what flavour?
Chamomile.
Are you a bit annoyed?
I think Solomon likes to think he's a creative spirit.
Yeah.
But I think often he doesn't have
creativity that is valuable.
In North London, Katie looks for ways to give a traditional dish a twist.
So here's the truffle oil.
It's strong tasting, John, isn't
it? Yes.
It's nice, I like it.
Here's the saffron, use a tiny amount.
Small amount would create quite a strong effect.
Yeah, yuzu is an oriental citrus fruit, a bit like a grapefruit. It's very, very sharply citrusy and tangy.
Katie's thinking about some very interesting, very new flavours.
Oh, it is. It's like lemony a bit, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
Interestingly, though, she doesn't know what they taste like. If she doesn't know and she wants to go into the restaurant business, how on earth does she think the average customer to a high street supermarket is going to know?
East London.
Hi, Sanjay.
Hi, Sanjay. Jeff, nice
to meet you. At a Michelin-starred restaurant.
Well, this is hopefully what ours is going to look like.
Right, OK.
Mark and Sanjay work on what type of pud to produce.
We're trying to get something that is going to be a bit, you know, have that luxurious feel to it, but actually is going to appeal to lots of different people.
Yeah.
So the saffron, the truffle oil, the lavender, the yuzu, the hibiscus.
Familiarity for the consumer,
yeah,
really. If you give people something that they don't understand, it's more than likely say, I don't know what that is.
For the mass market, pairing cherry and hibiscus in a trifle might give that familiarity as well as giving it a bit of an edge of something different.
As much as you want to create interest, you don't want to scare people.
Yeah, absolutely.
Set on trifle.
So I've thought of fancy full.
Next, cook up a brand name.
F-A-N-C-Y, full.
Sweet bliss, which was mine. Treat time, which was mine.
A trifle nice. Or a trifle good.
Sweet pleasure.
Sweet pleasure sounds a bit raunchy to me.
It's either a dessert or a massage parlour.
Oh, yeah.
In Soho, Bianca and Daniel go tea tasting for Rosine's cheesecake.
What we've got prepared for you is a tasting through a flight of four different teas.
Okay.
And so what you'll get is an idea of, at the high end, the flavors are much more pronounced. This particular oolong is an organic one from Jade Mountain in Taiwan. Smell it first, let the aroma go deep into your nose, let it roll across all the areas of your palate, and give it a good slurp to get the oxygen through it.
That doesn't resemble tea to me, because I'm obviously very uneducated. And in the world of tea.
Right.
In general.
I'm no tea expert. It was a little bit pretentious. I mean, I didn't really fit in very well there.
I think it's quite nice on the palate. It's quite easy.
Yep.
Very light, very fragrant.
Yeah.
Sweeter,
yes.
Flowery.
Very good.
Undertones.
Oolongs are very complex. They kind of really like Bianca, and Bianca seemed to suddenly know all about tea.
What does it go with? What would you like to see in this dessert with white tea?
It could be now like peach or apricot.
Apricot, okay.
2 p.m. Time for the teams to produce their puddings.
Oh, that really was not thought out. It's great.
Each must come up with three different flavours.
The first one that I want to try is to make strawberry and hibiscus flavour. Is this edible? Ah, that's horrible.
For Bianca and Daniel...
It's like glued on.
..a chance to whip up their cheesecake.
Are these magical eggs or something? The theme behind our product is tea. Green tea, oolong tea, black tea, you know, it's tea.
The first one's green tea...
..and white chocolate. It certainly smells good.
It's cheesecake with a tea twist in every one of them. I understand it. How it's going to look and taste is a different story.
I think so.
Way too much tea for me.
I don't think so.
No, there's, like, pure tea in that.
I think because I'm with more tea.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, then we should leave it roughly like that, then. If I think it's too much and you think it needs more.
On the other team...
I don't know if we need an actual photo of a trifle on there. I was thinking more just a graphic that represents it.
Katie's boys bring their trifle to life.
The crisscross background, I think that would be a really good background for our sleeve.
Yeah, I like that.
Hi, boys.
Yeah, so I just wanted to check on a name with you.
I've had a thought.
trifle is also a word for a little bit. So, you know, you'd say, oh, it's a trifle something. It means a little bit. So
yeah.
I thought a trifle different.
Yeah, I like that. That's good, Sanjay.
Fabulous.
I'm completely confident with the brand that we have produced. I came up with the name A Trifle Different, which I think is a really good play on the words.
This is coming together.
Yeah. I think we've done an excellent job. I think it will stand out on the shelves, and there's nothing about today that I would change.
Take me to the boardroom now, because we've got a winner.
Refining her recipes.
The guy in the shop told us that saffron would go well with berries.
Aspiring restaurateur, Katie.
I'm gonna even half that. Is it supposed to dissolve?
No.
No, I'm definitely being too overcautious with me saffron.
Okay, just be careful. That's all we've got.
Right. I really like that. But I think the saffron's just not strong enough.
In South London.
Can we try a few ideas for the logo that
we
have?
Roisin and Solomon pour their energy into teapot.
Do you think we could try the leaf one more time just to see if it makes the tea kind of stand out?
Yeah, yeah. No idea.
Yeah? I think that looks really premium because it's simple. I did fight really hard to be in the branding team. I think I've definitely proved my worth.
Maybe it does add another dimension to it.
Roisin. Maybe she does think I'm a bit of a loose cannon, but I've made sure that our branding's really fun. I've injected personality into it.
If I was going around and taking a gift, that could be something really nice. You know, even your girlfriend, you could pop that in the post.
Did you just send your post to your girlfriend a cheesecake?
Why not? You could. That's a nice gift, you know what I think? I think that's cute. I think that's the nice thing nice. You know, imagine if you, I gave you this. Why do you find that so funny?
£8.45.
I'm actually much more confident. I actually think it tastes good.
I don't know if the team will like it. I hope they will like it. But more importantly, I hope the people we're pitching to will like it. For me, that is probably the most important thing right now.
So we've actually created a cheesecake?
I'm very, very pleased with the product. I think it looks great. It doesn't look artificial in any way.
Really nice.
I'm really excited to show what we've got to the supermarket. I think it's the right product, and as long as the branding matches up, I think we're on to a winner.
Puddings perfected.
Absolutely smashed it.
Packaging signed off.
Yeah, I'm glad I'm in the branding.
Well,
this is good.
You didn't leave me much choice about that.
The teams head home. Tomorrow, pitch for sweet deals at the supermarkets. ...8 a.m.
Oh, morning.
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 It's going to be an easy pitch, to be honest with you, because it is really good quality.
For both teams, first peek at their puddings.
Here we go.
For Roisin, teapot.
Sophisticated cheesecake.
Oh, cool. Green.
How do you think?
It looks like a proper product.
Doesn't that look like a proper product?
It's a big bit, isn't it?
Yeah, blimey.
Putting their trifle to the test, Katie.
It's good, isn't it?
It's really good.
It's so good.
You like
it? It's so good.
That looks like a product you would see.
You can imagine it on a shelf.
You'd definitely pay £2 for that.
I'll do the first pitch.
Yeah.
Mark did the second one. Sanjay did the third one.
Absolutely
yeah.
Fine.
Yeah, brilliant.
Cool. Perfect.
While Katie takes a democratic approach...
I'm going to lead and I want Bianca to do it with me.
Roisin puts forward her pitching strategy.
Daniel, I know that you wanted to pitch. I'm going to see how it goes in the morning, and if it's a good formula, I'm not going to change it.
Yeah, okay.
You have a slightly different style, and I'm not sure if that's appropriate for this, so we'll see how it goes.
If you need us, I'd obviously love to be involved, but, you know, it's your decision.
Yeah.
Next product.
while half stay home to prepare their pitch.
I want this to be really slick, which is why I think you and I are the best people to do it.
No, I agree.
The rest head off to test their puds on the public.
I really wanted a pitch. That's the thing. We both good pitches.
I desperately wanted a pitch. And by the way, I didn't realise when I joined this team, Rasheen's actually in love with Bianca, by the way.
What we're trying to do is doing a classic English trifle, but giving a bit of a modern twist to it.
Giving supermarket customers a taste of his trifle.
Mmm. You like that? Yeah?
Very nice.
Sanjay.
I just like the balance of flavours. It just goes well together.
What would you give it out of 10?
10 out of 10.
10 out of 10, fantastic.
My middle name's generous, by the way.
I'm not sure about premium. I mean, I'm not sure it's distinguished from any other products I've seen on shelves.
It's not something I would shout about.
A couple of people have mentioned the fact that they're not sure if it would stand out on the shelves.
I just think it's too much.
OK.
It's too much going on.
But ultimately, we need to see what the supermarkets themselves think.
You can actually really taste the saffron, can't you?
Yep. It's lovely.
Which gives it a sort of, I don't know, a bit of a savoury flavour.
In West London to road test Teapot, Daniel and Solomon.
Hello.
Hey, guys, how's it going?
Good. How are you guys getting on?
Yeah, good. Just to let you know, we've been stuck in a lot of traffic, so we've literally just got to the supermarket.
I am quite concerned we won't be able to make it to the first pitch because of that.
OK. Look, if you can't make it to the first pitch, we're just going to have to go ahead. With...
Cheers.
Perfect. All right, thanks so much, guys.
Are you concerned that obviously Dan and Solomon won't be there?
I'm not at all concerned that Dan and Solomon won't be there.
No.
I really don't think it's going to make a difference.
No.
Do you see it making any difference?
Not in the slightest.
South London. Stocking over a million products for Rasheen and Bianca, megastore Asda.
Afternoon, hi.
Hello.
So, good afternoon. Thank you very much for having us here today. We bring you the tea-infused cheesecake, which we've called the Teapot. So, here we have lemon and Earl Grey cheesecake, the white chocolate and green tea cheesecake with coconut flakes, and the peach and oolong vanilla cheesecake.
So who will buy the Teapot? The treat seekers obviously are a really important market, you know, the grazing consumers. This is a premium dessert.
I don't get the indulgence and the luxuriousness.
You'd probably need to leave the tea bagging for a little bit longer, if I'm honest. I think, you know, that you've got really strong flavours with it. I think it just masks the delivery of that, and the brand is all about the tea.
Next, through the doors, Sanjay, Katie and Mark.
A direct quote from one lady was, as far as trifles go, you're not going to get better than that. There was a couple of questions here and there, but nothing negative whatsoever.
Brilliant.
Really?
So,
ready?
Yeah,
ready. Yeah.
Let's go and do it.
I'd like to introduce you to and share with you today our brand new luxury dessert, A Trifle Different. This is black cherry, saffron and honey. One lady in particular said that this is the best trifle I've ever tasted.
I really like two of your products. Your black cherry and saffron just leaves a strange taste in my mouth afterwards, which just, it's not going at all.
Katie's pitch to the big supermarket was not great.
It's overpowering and it doesn't actually enhance the flavour of that product anyway, does it?
No.
Crazy ingredient combinations are not what they're looking for, and they're certainly not interested in saffron in their custard.
Serving almost 6 million shoppers a week, location for Rasheen's second pitch, high-end supermarket Waitrose.
The first one went well. They asked a lot of questions, but it went well.
Yeah.
The pitch was pretty much seamless, so right. I want to stick with Bianca and I again with the pitch.
Okay. I can't put myself forward for any, like, ingredients.
No one is to say anything unless it actually adds value. I want it to be really slick and professional.
Yep.
No voices talking over each other or interrupting.
So,
and again, only if it adds value.
Is it not
value.
Worth having a point where, you know, we've done the market research, this is what we found, and we can talk a
I
bit about it to add a little bit
third,
to what we've done?
For the third pitch, I think we could potentially look at that, but I think right now we need
right.
to get in there.
OK.
The name itself, the Teapot, you know, it's a play on teapot. It's, you know, referencing the tea infusion and also the pot that it actually comes in.
We think this is also an added value for the consumer as well, and it's attractive looking, it's reusable, it has a variety of uses.
Guys, I'll tell you, I actually was one of the members present to the tea experts. I'm not a big tea drinker, if you like, but it really did smack me round the face, the idea of having green tea and these flavours. So I'm not even a tea enthusiast, but yet I really did buy into the concept of having these tea cheesecakes.
One of the interesting things about this is that tea is very delicate,
yeah.
And cheesecake is quite a fatty dessert, so makes the ability to taste, it's...
I mean, obviously your palate may be slightly more sophisticated than mine, so you're wanting to get hit a lot with the tea, but myself, who doesn't drink a lot of green tea, really does taste it.
But,
and we went, yeah, we did the market research and they did taste it.
What we would say is that definitely we would take on board, we can definitely deliver on the stronger, punchier tea flavour. Less than 5 minutes before the pitch, I've given them really clear instructions on what to do, and they go in and do the opposite. I know that you really want to speak, and yeah, I know you really want this, but just sometimes bite, yeah, your tongue, because it's sometimes repetitive.
Okay.
It's not about speaking for the sake of speaking, and I don't know when people are going to realise that.
I thought it was just a little bit embarrassing, to be honest. I felt, you know, was it not a bit monotoned? Oh, I'm sorry, I just got a bit bored. I literally got a bit bored.
We have to stop this, you know. You know,
before
it was
it
going
gets out of control.
It was going really well.
I quite liked the product before that pitch. I feel like she undersold it. She's put me off the product.
Lunchtime. Pushing Katie on personnel.
Good guy, great bloke, but is Sanjay the guy you want stood in front of the largest supermarket in the UK?
Mark.
He was in the boardroom for not selling.
Really?
Yeah, bear me in mind for the third one. I've said it. I've laid it out there. Hi.
Hi, Sanjay.
Listen, I've been having a think about this next pitch.
And I'd really like you to lead on this one.
So you want me to do the Waitrose one now?
Yes, please.
My thought process is, if you do the introduction...
Yeah.
I'll talk through the actual product like I did in the last pitch.
Hang on, so why am I not leading my own pitch? Why am I having to have help on my pitch?
Given that I made the product, I've got a really good understanding of it.
Right. I'm confident in doing the whole pitch by myself,
to be honest. Right.
I'm perfectly able to stand up in a room and lead a pitch.
OK. We'll see you there.
Cool. See you shortly.
Bye.
Bye.
I don't need to take tips from Katie or Mark in terms of pitching. I'm confident in my own style. I think I can just about remember the layers in a trifle.
So what we're trying to create is a modern twist on an English favourite and an English classic. If I just encourage you to...
have a look.
Absolutely. One of your customers, a direct quote when they tasted this trifle in particular was, as far as trifles go, it doesn't get much better than that.
Okay, I think something going forward you need to really take into account is the amount of saffron. Saffron is one of the most expensive ingredients in the world, as you know.
Have you used it for colour or flavour?
Both.
Both. Because it's quite earthy. On the branding, that it doesn't give me the signals that this is a premium range.
At this supermarket, they sell some very high-end products. Trifle's a big seller for them, but the branding really let them down.
It doesn't feel top-tier at all.
I know.
I'm disappointed.
It didn't look premium enough, and it certainly didn't say luxury to them.
Mid-afternoon. With over 3,000 stores nationwide,
I want to inject more personality into it.
OK, but just keep it really snappy.
Mine's ridiculously snappy.
Yeah, OK.
Last chance for Roisin's team, Tesco.
So why have we chosen tea? We have identified tea infusions as the next trend to take over the dessert market and take the dessert market by storm.
The lemon, wow, is really, really good.
Really hits you.
Mm. Really good. A little tad tart, but... Yeah, I'm tasting the tea as well.
OK.
For me, I would buy it for a gift. You know, if I got back from an exam, leaving it in the housemate's fridge.
Hi, I'm Daniel. We did go consumer testing today. The feedback was pretty good, guys. So a 22-year-old, this was a lady, really good, and I can really taste the green tea coming through. So they like the product, they like the look, they're passionate about our brand as much as our team are, and we hope you are too. If there's any other questions, guys, or any other feedback, we'd love to hear it.
What I like about it is you've taken the nation's favourite drink and one of the nation's favourite desserts, and you've blended them with a bit of fun and personality. And I like the packaging. It's very understated. It's very confident, very clear.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you very much.
Have a good evening. Bye-bye.
Straight away, they said they like the flavours. I mean, that's what we want to hear, isn't it?
I think they've really thought about this.
And I actually like their presentation.
And also, you know the woman on the left?
Yeah.
She, like, winked at the end. She winked at me.
Come on, let's not get ahead of ourselves.
Should we go have a cheesecake business?
She,
you know,
she genuinely winked at me. Yeah? She winked at me. That's a good sign. That means I'm going to buy.
She winked at me.
Stepping forward for Trifle.
Do you go to the racetrack and leave your prized stallion in the shed? No.
Sales manager Mark.
Guys, the luxury dessert market has just reached £1.45 billion in yearly revenues, and it's an expanding market, particularly in the luxury dessert range. Leading brands are seeing sales as £35 million and seeing annual increases of £20 year on year in the last 5 years. What's making luxury desserts popular? People are wanting restaurant quality desserts at home that they can enjoy with their friends and families. We've kept that in mind, and in the design centre of our dessert, a trifle different. What we've tried to do and what we have done is create a dessert of restaurant quality that you can buy for your friends and family and enjoy at home. Sorry, guys.
Would you like some water?
Yes, please, that would be great. I'm very, very sorry. Sorry, guys.
And what we'll do is, I'm sure whilst Mark's having some water, we'll hand out the first of the three trifles.
Frankly, that was Mark's worst nightmare. By God, he was nervous.
So the second one that you've got now is the blackberry and yuzu, finished with dyed yuzu fruit.
Did you say dyed?
Dried.
He stumbled, he got confused. Mark should have held it together much better than he did.
It just feels like you're playing too much in trifle land and traditional land in terms of its look and feel. It feels just a bit everyday, that's all.
Sorry, guys. That was so embarrassing. I couldn't get a water.
Yeah, if you can't, I could tell you're struggling, but I couldn't see the water.
Pitch is over. Pudding orders, if any, will be placed tonight. Results will be served up in the boardroom.
You can go through to the boardroom now.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
So, summit. I made Roisin the project manager, and I understand your business idea is a food business.
Yes, that's right.
So, how did you get on then? What did you do? I see there's a name on there called Teapot.
Teapot, yeah.
So, you're the first people to make a chocolate teapot. Right, so how was the team split up then?
Solomon didn't feel confident going to the manufacturing side.
So you didn't want to be in the kitchen, Solomon?
Correct, yeah. I wanted to place myself on the branding team. I really thought that's where my skill set lied.
You pitch yourself to your project manager, that's where your expertise lies.
Yeah.
I think rather than pitching himself as having good skills in branding, I think he said, I can't be in the kitchen. I wouldn't be any good in the kitchen.
Okay. That's another way of looking at it, I suppose.
Yeah, that's more of the reality.
Right. Was he a good choice then to take him with in the end?
I think the branding would have come out either way. Solomon did contribute to areas of it, he did.
I think it was as well. He eased himself into that role alongside you. I thought he was bouncing up and down with little ideas. I liked the way he worked, actually.
And who's the target market for all this stuff, then?
We had treat seekers, we had grazing consumers who would consume...
Who?
Grazing consumers who would consume...
Grazing consumers?
So, basically, the weekly shop is...
What are they, a donkey or a goat, are they, or what?
We did our market research, and Bianca and Daniel actually went to a tea specialist.
What'd you do there?
So we spoke with the tea trader and a tea sommelier.
Got a sore throat today, Daniel?
No.
No, this was his house.
Not at all.
I've got a new stance. This is your new kind of approach.
Not at all.
Yeah.
So Daniel and I went to speak to a tea sommelier, and they.
The tea sommelier.
Yes.
Bloody, I've got these names coming up here today. Grazing consumers, tea sommelier.
Yeah.
Lord Sugar, to be honest, that's part of the reason.
Oh, here he is. Hold on, sorry. I was merely joking. Tell me, Roisin, did you deliberately want to keep him away from pitching?
Yeah, I said to Daniel I didn't want him to pitch because I wasn't entirely happy with the guy's contribution to the second pitch, so I asked
You wasn't happy with their contribution?
You didn't speak.
No, you did speak. You just didn't have any value when you spoke. Yeah.
They were probably thinking, what the hell are you doing here, rather than holding the door open for the girls.
Shouting doesn't help.
Actually, they liked Daniel.
Oh, thank you, Nick.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
All right, enough said. So... let's move on to Team Tenacity. You had Sanjay's joined you. How'd you enjoy joining this team, Sanjay?
I really enjoyed joining the team. I think it just felt like I'd fitted straight in.
You did have a little dig at Bianca, though, didn't you?
Did you?
Did I?
Covering her back all the time, pleased to get away.
I may have made a comment along those lines.
Not may, you did.
A joke.
What did you choose?
So we decided to go with trifle. So the first one was strawberry and hibiscus. We decided...
Hibiscus?
Yeah.
Do you play for Real Madrid? So you got your product, you now go and do a little bit of market research before we go into pitches. Who did that?
I did that, Lord Sugar.
Did you get all excellent feedback? Or...
Majority of it was very good. There was one or two comments about they didn't feel it would stand off the shelf, but if 6 out of 7 people are saying one thing and one person saying something different, I decided that the majority would be the one to go with.
Actually, what you should do is focus on anybody who says anything bad. Say, well, they've got a point. I'll preempt that when I go into pitches with the retailers. Well, anyway, after that, then, you go to the first... pitch. And how'd that go?
One of the panellists particularly liked two of the flavours. She wasn't as keen on the saffron, but was really keen on the other two.
I don't know about not keen. She thought it was disgusting. Inedible. Threatened the bin.
And then finally, we went to the giant supermarket chain, yeah?
Yeah.
I led that one, Lord Sugar. To be honest with you, I went in and dropped my bundle at the start and completely...
What do you mean, dropped your bundle?
I just got a bit overwhelmed by the situation. I wanted to do a good job so badly that I let that overwhelm me. And even, to be honest with you, my toes were shaking in my shoes. And it just... the situation beat me.
That's surprising, Mark.
No, it was very embarrassing, Lord Sugar. It was, very embarrassing, but it won't happen again.
Mm. Nobody else has buckled.
OK. They've phoned in all of these retailers and they've actually given us what their orders are. Karen, perhaps you'd like to start off with the megastore, first of all.
Well, I hate to say this, Katie, but they didn't like your pitch. But they did like your product. They hated the saffron, so they won't be ordering any of that. But with a few tweaks to the other two, they placed an order of 13,500 units. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Right. Nick, how did the... how did Summit do?
Yeah, well, the megastore felt it was niche. In fact, too niche for them. It's a fat zero, I'm afraid.
Karen, let's talk about the high-end supermarket for Tenacity.
They thought you'd spotted a gap in the market, but it just wasn't premium enough for them on the branding, so unfortunately, no orders.
Mm-hmm. And Nick, for that high-end supermarket?
Better news. Bit of work to be done. Order 5,500.
And, well, finally, the large supermarket chain, the giant supermarket chain, Karen.
Again, they were really confused about the branding. Didn't think it was premium. Thought the product was OK, but the branding let it down. And I'm sorry to say, no orders.
Well, Nick, finally, with you, the large supermarket chain.
Subject to tweaking, they thought it was wonderful. 20,000.
Yes. 20,000, right. That's good.
Big order.
That is very, very good. So, we have 25,500 orders for Summit and 13,500 for Tenacity. Very well done. Very well done. As your task was all about sweet things, I'm sending you to sample some macaroons and martinis on board an exclusive yacht. The same one that was used in the James Bond film, The World Is Not Enough. So enjoy it, and I'll see you on the next task. Okay?
Thank you very much.
Okay.
Thank you, Nick.
Thank you, Nick.
Yes. Did it.
Come on, guys.
Go off now and have a little chat amongst yourselves. I'll call you back in here and we'll decide who's going to be remaining in the process. OK? Off you go.
Thanks, Dad, sugar.
Hi there.
Congratulations. Oh, welcome to the Macaroon and Martini experience.
So thank you very much.
This
thank
is
you.
Amazing.
Cheers.
Away.
It was amazing.
Yeah.
A little bit like James Bond.
You look like James Bond.
You do look a bit like James Bond. This feels really good. This was such a huge task. And not only did we win, but we won so well.
Cheers, guys.
Cheers, cheers, guys. Cheers. Well done.
I'm really disappointed. Really, really disappointed.
I've never been more stumped as to what the problem is. Of course, I'm under extra pressure. If I want Lord Sugar to invest in a food-related business with me, I've got to show that I can create a food product. I just hope that my track record and the process is enough to make sure I stay in it.
I'd be pretty angry if I left the process. I don't think I haven't done anything wrong.
Mark spent all day preparing for a pitch, which he then fluffed.
Sure, you can always do things better, but I feel I've been an example candidate.
Katie created the product, so if there's a problem with the flavouring, that's the reasons why they didn't order it, then Katie is to blame. It's that simple.
Yes, Lord Sugar.
Can you send the three of them in, please?
Yes, Lord Sugar. You can go through to the boardroom now.
I asked you to make a high-class pudding. Clearly, two of the major retailers didn't see it that way. You went to the kitchen, Katie?
I put myself in the kitchen because of the three of us, I felt I was best placed. Desserts are not my strong point, but what I did do when I got to the kitchen was throw myself in like I have done on every single task.
Why are you asking to come into a business for me to do with food? For example, you've got this saffron. A, it tasted horrible. B, it's quite clear that you have no concept whatsoever of costs either. The amount of saffron that you put in there, you'd leave yourself about 2 pence left for making all the rest of the stuff.
My expertise lies in taking foods that are traditionally unhealthy and making them healthy. Yeah. And I've never claimed to be the strongest cook. And certainly in this restaurant that I propose in my business plan, I don't plan to be the chef there.
The saffron, you know, was useless. The branding, which you two are responsible for, was miles off beam. They're not sure about the gingham, and the splodges on the packaging looked like someone had, you know, sneezed with a mouthful of custard. Bad. All round bad.
I'm also concerned to a certain extent with the third pitch. I've seen Mark be a lot stronger than he was.
Yeah.
And that's why I put him in the third pitch, because
I don't think the pitch is any reason an order wasn't made. We did miss the mark on the branding. I can see that, and we have that big concerns around the actual content in the trifle and how it tastes.
The main issue that's come up more often than not is the old-fashioned branding, and for that, for the gingham and for the...
Well, that's you, isn't
no,
it?
No, that's
then?
Mark. That was Mark, the gingham and the old-fashioned...
You were there. You were fully behind it. You two were ready to go home at 4 o'clock in the afternoon.
I'll put my hands up and say that I was behind it, but I'm no branding expert.
Yeah.
I'm no branding expert, but...
The gingham was my suggestion. 80% of the purchase decision is made by the taste of the product, and we've got that wrong.
I've got the measure of this task now. I don't want to talk about it anymore. Katie, I don't wish to suppress people's enthusiasm, but a sole trader, you can be. It don't make you an entrepreneur.
Lord Sugar, my business plan is to open a healthy eating restaurant so people can eat out without feeling like they're missing out on the foods that they love.
So this restaurant, where is it going to be?
In Sunderland. There is a real need for something like this.
Katie, you know nothing about running a restaurant.
I worked in a restaurant from the age of 15 as a waitress. I've worked front of house, I've worked back of house.
Yeah, I've been to McDonald's also, but I wouldn't know how to run the infrastructure there. Sanjay, you've spent most of your working life in banking circles, OK? And you are proposing a website business which has something to do with social networking with people in the fitness world.
There's 4.9 million gym memberships in the UK at the moment. Taking those people and putting them on a network where they can connect with each other.
Where's the money?
The money is based on paper impression, pay-per-click advertising. You would also have people such as Katie, personal trainers, who pay a fee to be a member of that website to be able to market themselves.
Sanjay, I think you are deluded in thinking that is a lucrative business. Mark, are you all right? Have you given up on this process or what?
Lord Sugar, I want to be here more than anybody else. I never fail in business. I never, ever fail.
You failed in front of Tesco's, Mark.
Lord Sugar, yesterday I felt as if my opportunity to show you my business plan was hanging in the balance of the pitch, and I do really want to be here. That played on me and I didn't perform as well as I would have liked to. I believe I have been good. I've never been brought back into the boardroom on the failure of a task.
There's been a few occasions when I think people thought you should have been taken back into the boardroom.
It doesn't matter.
Why wasn't he then?
Pardon?
Why wasn't he?
Because he's quite good at...
Why are you joining in, mate? I didn't speak when you were speaking and you were talking
Lord Sugar, ask me a question.
Lord Sugar, 18 months ago I came to the UK and I started with one of the top digital agencies, an internet marketing consultant selling digital advertising. Within 1 year, I was the top internet marketing consultant in the UK for revenue growth.
In the UK?
In the UK. I had 7 staff under me, and in 18 months I turned over 1.5 million.
Right, OK. Look, I'm going to have another chat with Karen and Nick. They've been following you for the past 10 weeks. Step outside and I'll call you back in shortly. Katie, completely clueless in the kitchen, but the calming factor on many occasions. The thing is, simple, hard graft, regretfully, is not enough.
I think Mark really pushed to go to the last big supermarket, and he knew how important it was, and unfortunately, Alan, he choked.
Very unusual, isn't it, for you? Sanjay has spent his whole life in banking, and I believe he wants some form of website in the fitness market.
Alan, it seems more of a whim than a business idea.
Yes, Lord Sugar.
Yeah, send the three of them in, please.
Yes, Lord Sugar.
Lord Sugar, we'll see you now.
I don't wish to sound blasé here. I don't wish to demean anybody. And there are a lot of sole traders in our country. They are the backbone of the economy. They might make something like £50,000 or £60,000 a year and pay two or three staff. However, having said all that, I'm not interested in that market. I'm looking for big bucks. I'm going to invest £250,000 with a young person into a business, OK, that's going to grow it into something big.
So the margin...
And Sanjay, you see where I'm coming from?
Yep.
Where, and where's your revenues? What are your revenues going to be?
So I put my projections to work up to a net profit in year five of £1.1 million.
Really?
Yes.
That's impossible with pay-per-click.
Pardon?
That's impossible.
I've given five... There's five different revenue streams, one of which is pay-per-click.
You don't think it's possible?
It's not possible. Banner advertising in that industry, there's not enough search.
But if you were listening, I've just explained that pay-per-click advertising is one of those, and there are four other streams within my business plan that generate revenue.
Katie, you've been listening to this conversation.
Yeah, Lord Sugar, I think with my business...
You're out your depth here as far as money is concerned.
I originally was one of the sole traders that you mentioned, and I'm very, very proud of that. I'm ready to go to the next level now. When I've looked, I've worked
the
really
restaurant
hard.
The restaurant takes a couple of grand a week, you know, so what? You've got staff and this, that and the other. You might make a couple of £100 at the end of the week.
Lord Sugar, at the end of the day, the business these guys are proposing is only a splash in the ocean that I want to create. We could have a very big business in a very short space
Lord
of time.
Sugar, what I have is a very strong client base. I already have the database. I already have the people that want to be part
but
of
what's
this.
What's a restaurant going to turn over in a year? What, 150 grand?
What have you got? You're good at sales, but have you shown that you can actually do the strategic thought?
Internet marketing.
Can you do the strategic thought?
I've got a business model that can be replicated in local locations throughout the UK. It's a business model that could go worldwide, but I know what works and I know what people like.
Listen.
I know this market.
Look, Katie, yeah, you've been Miss Common Sense, a good organiser, I would say. But I honestly cannot see how a restaurant business starting from scratch in a very niche market is going to work with you and I. And on that basis, Katie, I do wish you the best of luck in your ongoing business, but in this particular case, it is with regret that you're fired.
Thank you for the opportunity. Karen and Nick, it's been lovely meeting you. Thank you.
Thank you. Good luck, Katie.
Everything that I've done in the process. I think I've learned skills that I didn't even know that I had. I've outperformed people who do these skills as part of their job every day, and I'm really proud of everything that I've done here.
You know, one of the easiest things for me to do today, gentlemen, is to just say au revoir to both of you. Mark, why is your business proposition better than his?
Because...
Do you believe in his business
idea? It won't work, Lord Sugar. I work in that industry, and to generate revenue from that, it will look nice and it will be friendly for people to use.
You don't know anything about my business plan. I don't see how you can start saying that my business plan won't work when you don't know.
It's a niche industry. It's a niche industry targeted at fitness people. I'm talking about generating revenue from advertising. I will make £1 million in year one. Will you do that?
I will make £1.1 million in year five. Have you ever shown anything in terms of strategy, direction, and leading a team? You can do sales, Mark, but can you actually think things through, run a team? Because you haven't done a very good job of it in the process so far. Selling, you're great at. If you want a salesman, Lord Sugar, Mark's your man. He's fantastic. Look,
I'm waiting to hear about the money.
It's a great idea. There's no money in it, mate.
There is money in it. You've got the pay-per-click advertising. You've got fitness professionals. Once you've built up an active user base, that is a database of people that fitness professionals can target to generate business.
I understand the database type of thing. I'm six of one and half a dozen of another at the moment, to be honest with you. Sanjay, you are an intelligent and clever fellow, no question of it, and you've done very well in the banking circles. Mark, you are a good salesman, and the proposition that you're putting forward is all about sales, but there are so many of you out there doing it. Sanjay, I don't have the confidence in this website that you're talking about. I really don't. And so, Sanjay, you're fired.
Thank you very much, Lord Sugar. Thank you, Karen. Thank you, Ned.
Good luck, Sanjay.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Can I speak again, Lord Sugar?
No.
Or...
No. Last chance.
Thank you, Lord Sugar.
Go back to the house, okay?
Thank you very much. Thank you, Nick. Thank you, Karen.
I'm really disappointed. However, I'm really proud of what I've achieved over the past few weeks, and I've learnt and demonstrated some skills that from a corporate banking background that I didn't know I had, and I'm going to make sure that I turn that into a positive.
I think Mark screwed up completely, but his previous task performances, I think it's borderline impossible to let him go.
I think Mark and Katie are coming back.
You reckon?
I think Mark or Katie, and I think either one would be worthy of being here.
Mm. Lord Sugar is a pretty rare guy. He could just get rid of them all.
Oh! Yeah.
Room for one more. Oh,
welcome back! Oh, my goodness.
Thank you.
Are you the only one, Mark?
That's it.
What?
No last way. One.
I wish I had better news.
That's it.
She's gone to
that's
look
it.
For Katie.
Yeah.
Katie's
take
gone.
A seat.
We knew
a seat.
It was you.
No way! I don't believe it! Are you serious?
That's it. It was the toughest boardroom I've ever experienced. It's all about you now and your business plan. It's not like what happened on the tasks. This is the final five.
Yeah.
Well done.
Oh,
yeah. I wasn't going before Daniel.
Now just five candidates remain. Lord Sugar's search for his next business partner continues. Next time...
I'm going to put you in front of four of my trusted advisors.
Business plans blasted.
It's a bloody disgrace.
I think you're busking this.
I see that as being deceitful.
Battle lines drawn.
Daniel's the best to go first.
Why?
Well, if you go after him, you'll look good, won't you?
And in the boardroom...
It seems like they have a bit of a petty squabble going on.
A fight for the finish.
This business idea, in your mind, is a runner. In my mind, it is not. You're fired.